Hello and welcome to Prusa Printers Developer Log. The number of models and users on Prusa Printers has been growing at a pretty incredible rate. There are now over 35,000 designs. And we have collected a lot of feedback, feature requests and general suggestions on how to improve the site. That's why we thought you might be interested to see what we are currently working on. So without further ado, let's get started. Most of the changes that we are working on are on the edit page. That's when you are creating a new print or editing an existing one. If we take a look at a somewhat complex project like the Prusa enclosure and go into the file section, we can see that there are a lot of different files and the project can be quite confusing. The 3D thumbnails do help, but it's still not ideal. That's why we are adding the option to add folders. Folders behave just like you expect them to. You can drag files and put them inside a folder. You can rename the folder. You can also select multiple files and drag them inside a folder all at once, which is a nice time saver. You can create as many folders as you like, and you can open and close them to make it a little bit easier to find the files you're looking for. This is how it looks once it's saved. Others will see the folders just like you created them, and it will make it much easier to orient yourself in bigger projects. You will newly have the ability to add notes to each individual model file. So you can, for example, specify if a model needs supports, if it should be printed from a specific material, or, for example, how many pieces should be printed. You can also rename the files directly here, which is amazing. I'm sure you're also guilty of not always naming your files ideally, but when it's this easy to rename them in here, I'm sure that many of you will take the time to give them nice and descriptive names. There is a whole new section called Other Files. We got a lot of requests to be able to upload Arduino sketches, PDF files, and a whole bunch of different file formats, but we didn't want to have those files just randomly mixed in together with the 3D models, so there's now a separate section for them. Another improvement on the edit page is a new text editor. It was already possible to stylize text. We supported the markup language, but it wasn't very user-friendly for our users. Instead, we now have a WYSIWYG editor, which I'm sure you are familiar with from other applications. You can add headings, links, bolds. If you add a YouTube link, it automatically embeds a YouTube player. What's maybe the best part is that you can add images directly here in the text. So these images will not be displayed in the gallery, they will be really displayed in the text, and that makes a lot of sense for wiring diagrams and basically any instructions images. So you will find them in the text instead of somewhere randomly in the gallery. Of course, there is still a separate photo section, which is only for pictures that will be displayed in the gallery. A different thing that we are working on is the way the page loads. If we emulate a really, really slow internet speed, you can see how things just sort of pop into existence as they load. And it can be really annoying to navigate through a page that works like this. You can accidentally click on something that you didn't want to click on. You have to wait for an element that you know you want to click to load, only to leave the page a second later. So we have improved this. There are now placeholders and the site shows you something as soon as possible. The layout doesn't change as things load. There are already the placeholders so that you don't accidentally click on something else. And even on connections that aren't this terribly slow, it will make the site a lot more responsive and nice to navigate through. So that's it for now. We have other things that we are working on in parallel, but we are not ready to show them yet. This was sort of an experiment. Let us know if you'd like to see more devlogs like this to see what's happening on Prusa Printers. Happy printing!